Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to go over five essential tools that I use in Adobe Illustrator every day. And actually, these aren't necessarily tools, they're just parts of Illustrator that I find really useful. All right, let's get started. The first tool is the Group Selection tool. It's right underneath the Direct Selection tool. Now, I use this one so often that I made a keyboard shortcut to it. I just type G and it'll automatically bring me to this tool. Now, here's why it's so useful. Let's say I want to make this part of the A, which is punched out, a little wider. I can get on my Group Selection tool, click right on the edge of that, and so it's the only thing selected. The rest of the A isn't selected. And then hit E, which is my Free Transform tool, and make it a little bigger. I can rotate it and just do whatever I want with it. I'm gonna undo. But I just wanted to show you that. That's one of the very useful ways to use the Group Selection tool. Now, another really useful thing that this will do, if you use your regular selection tool to select text, it'll select everything, even if they're ungrouped. And these are grouped right now. I'm gonna ungroup them with Shift Command G. But right now I have the N only, and it selected all these parts. So what I'm gonna do is get my Group Selection tool. I'll click right on the edge of that, and that means all these other pieces are not selected. So I could hide this, then hit Command Y or Control Y, then just select the pieces that I don't want. Accidentally got that one, so I'm gonna hold Shift and deselect it. And now delete this. Now I'll go to Object, Show All. And now we have the N without these little punch-out areas. So the Group Selection tool makes it really easy to click right on the edge of something and be able to select that whole shape. Now, if you use your regular Direct Selection, you'll actually only be selecting that piece. You don't have the whole shape selected. Now, there is one more way to use the Group Selection tool, and that's to select groups of things. So these little dots down here are grouped. Now, it really does matter how they're grouped, but we can find out pretty easily. So I'll click once, and I'll click twice on the same area, and that gets the whole group. If I click again, it'll get the next part that's grouped, which are all these little dot areas. And then I can click again on one of those and get the next part. So you can select different parts of the group. So it will keep on selecting more and more of the group as you click, until you get to the final one, which in this case was the clipping mask. Okay, so that is one I use every single time I open Illustrator. It's super useful in my workflow. The second tool I use all the time, which is not really a tool, is outline mode. So it's right up here under View Outline. And this gives you the wireframe of everything. I'm gonna hit Command Y or Control Y to get back out. Now I wanna select these bushes, but if I try to do that, I click the whole thing, which is not what I want. So I'm gonna do it with Command Y or Control Y. Now let's say I just wanted to select this green area and move it over or something like that. I can hit Command Y or Control Y. I'm gonna use my Group Selection again, select all these pieces and lock them with Command 2 or Control 2. And I'll do the same up here. I don't wanna select that, so I'll hold Shift and click it. And then I'll hit Command 2 or Control 2 to lock those. Okay, so now I've got all these pieces. I don't want this, so I'll hold Shift and deselect that. And then I can move these over. Then I'll hit Command Y or Control Y to get back out. Maybe I'll move them down a little bit. And now this part doesn't match up, which brings me to my next favorite tool, which is the Pencil tool. Now you can use the Pencil tool to redraw parts of a path. And that's what I'm going to do with this dark green area back behind here. So I have it selected. I'm gonna hit N to get my pencil tool, which is right over here. And then I'm just going to kind of draw this shape around the pieces that I want. And I have to end up going the same way on that path. So let me undo that with Command Z. So I started going this way on the shape, and then I varied. I went off and did my own thing. But in order for this pencil tool to work this way, you have to end up right back on that line, going the same direction. Now we can also hold Option to get to the Smooth tool and kind of smooth out parts if we want to do that. That will only work if you set it up here in your preferences. So double click your pencil and it's right here. Option key toggles to smooth tool. If you're on a PC, this will probably say Alt key toggles to smooth tool. So it's either Option or Alt. My next favorite tool is the Q tool. That's the Lasso tool, and you can just hit Q on your keyboard to get to it. And I like this one for many of the same reasons. It makes it easier to select things. So if I want to make this mushroom taller, I'm going to zoom in on that. I'll hit Command Y or Control Y to get into preview mode. With my group selection tool, I'm going to select all this grass and hide it with Command 3. And same over here, just kind of get rid of everything but the mushroom. Okay, so if I hit Command Y or Control Y, I can see that really the only thing we have is the mushroom now. I'm going to hit Command Y or Control Y to get back in here, and then I'll hit Q to get to my lasso tool. The lasso tool will select whatever you draw around. So I'm going to draw around the cap of the mushroom. So we have all the filled points selected. I'm going to switch over to my A tool, which is the direct selection tool. Click on one of those points and just drag this up so it's taller. Now it looks like I accidentally got a piece of this I didn't want. I don't think it bothers me. So I'm going to hit Command Y or Control Y to get back, and then I'm going to unhide everything with Object Show All. And now our little mushroom is a lot taller. Okay, and then the fifth tool that I really love is the Magic Wand tool. And you can get to it by hitting Y on your keyboard. It's right up here. Now this tool will select all similar colors. So if we click on this green color, it's going to get all similar greens. I'm on my Y tool. I'm just going to hit Enter or Return to bring up the options. And I'll change my tolerance to 20. You can see that we also have some other options in here. I always leave this at fill color, but you can select stroke color, stroke weight, opacity, blending mode, and all that. I'm going to deselect with Shift Command A or Shift Control A, and then I'm going to select the green again. Now it got all these greens, but it didn't get the greens in here. But the nice thing about doing this is you can change all these colors at once with the Recolor artwork tool. Maybe you want everything to be a little bit lighter. You can pull this slider and watch it change in real time. You can also just click in here and change the hues of the colors. I'm going to go ahead and undo that. Now, as you probably noticed, I use these tools all together. So I'm always flipping back and forth between Command Y, Control Y, which is the outline mode. I'll get in there and then redraw it with my pen tool, then hit Command Y or Control Y to get back out. So those are my five favorite tools, the ones that I really use the most in Adobe Illustrator. All right, I hope this video is useful for you. If you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.